Nili mule mukimbia, nikaenda vunjika mkono. Sasa wakanipiga makofi huko kumasiki. Wakakuya kunipiga chini. Wakanifunga kitambala. Wakunitia mai kiuni na miguyo. Sasa wakifanya vile kuanza asubuhi na mvua ilikuwa inanyesha.
Rape is used as a weapon of mass destruction in Eastern Congo. It's used by militias to attack villages and destroy them economically, politically, socially, and psychologically. This project is an outgrowth of some research we did previously for the International Criminal Court that is an attempt to understand an anthropological footprint of mass rape in villages in the Eastern Congo. Mass rape fosters a breakdown of the community in its entirety, and that starts with a norm in Congolese society according to which men must divorce their wives if they've been raped and can't marry a woman who's been raped. So that not only breaks down the family, it breaks down the economy. And it breaks down the economy because the women are the farmers. So if they're divorced, they are thrown out of the house and thrown off the land. So a mass rape of, say, 20, 30, 40 women in a village of 300 or 400 people throws the economy into a tailspin. There's often a rebellion of sorts against the elders and the chief of the village, so it breaks down politically, and of course psychologically it breaks down as well, with surging rates of PTSD and depression. Our previous research documented very robustly this effect. Our current effort is to try to dampen all of those adverse effects of mass rape, because if those villages can be repaired, if those villages aren't broken by the mass rape attacks, then the incentive for militias to carry them out diminishes. In early 2014, we established a new NGO, the Restore the Villages Project, and this project will do 5 interventions in villages that have suffered mass rape attacks. We will do a medical intervention where the women are treated for physical trauma, of course, and where they are treated for any potential STDs. Some of the husbands are concerned that their wives have STDs. This will take away that concern. Of course, it's crucial to the women's health. Second, we're doing a psychosocial intervention, embedding a psychologist and 2 social workers in each village that suffered a mass rape attack to try to work through some of the psychological and social issues surrounding rape so that the family stays together. Third, we are doing a microfinance intervention where we are creating a women's cooperative in each of these villages, taking mostly women victims, a few non-victims, so that there are no jealousies or reduced jealousies in the village, and providing them with capital and training so that they can learn a business or learn a skill that they can use to remain engaged in the village's economy. If they remain engaged in the village's economy, they're integrated into the village by definition, so their expulsion from the village isn't taking place. The fourth intervention is an ecumenical one, where we are having a Catholic priest, a Protestant minister, a Muslim sheikh come into the village and preach what those religions preach about this kind of thing: compassion, the sanctity of family, the sanctity of marriage, and try to impress these norms upon the villagers. The fifth and final intervention is a judicial intervention. We are working with the American Bar Association Rule of Law Initiative to bring a mobile court trial to the villages where the mass rape has occurred when a perpetrator or a person responsible for these mass atrocities can be found. And they have been found. Various commanders of these militias have been put on trial in the past and are going to continue to be put on trial, but now in or near the villages where the atrocities occurred. We're hopeful that this will impress upon the villagers that their justice can be done, but that also that by identifying the perpetrator as the culprit instead of the victim as being somehow responsible or somehow sullied or a source of shame, that instead the blame will go where it belongs, and that is on the perpetrator. We are very carefully assessing the impact of each of our interventions. We're doing surveys before and after the interventions to see what their effects are. And our plan is to then fine-tune the interventions and the combination of interventions so that we come up with an optimal way to spend the resources we have to try to dampen these adverse effects of mass rape. The Restore the Villages Project is indebted to Diana Jenkins not only because she is the benefactor whose help has allowed us to launch this project, but also because of her ideas about how to intervene in a society that suffered mass violence based on her own experiences. Those ideas, those sensibilities have been invaluable in planning our This is a long-term research project. We're going to be collecting data for at least 2 years, and we expect to have a very large database so that we can do a very rigorous study of the effects of these interventions so we can understand them, so we can understand ways in which they don't work, ways in which they work, and why. So any results we have at this point are very preliminary, but those preliminary results are encouraging. We know already that people who witness or hear about a mobile court trial for rape are considerably more likely to blame the perpetrator, the man who commits the rape, than in villages where there is no mobile court, where there is no judicial process, where a substantially smaller proportion of the population blames the perpetrator and instead blames others, including, in some cases, the woman. Preliminary data also shows that people who participate in the ecumenical service are substantially and significantly more likely to show compassion or feel compassion for the victim than people who don't participate in it. So that's exactly one of the effects we were hoping the ecumenical service would have, and the data tends to confirm at this point that that is in fact taking place.
I think what Richard Steinberg is doing is great, because he is transforming a very remote experience in something that people in a very good university could understand and include in the curriculums and transform into knowledge. That's amazing.